Hey y'all, Todd here, and welcome back to another Wellness Talks Brief. How to add mindfulness practices to everyday routines. Now, a lot of times when I'm working with individuals in beginning to put in a new mindfulness practice, everybody thinks that they have to take this great endeavor and a huge amount of time, 15, 20, half hour, to a mindfulness practice, kind of like I have to go to the gym and I have to be at the gym for 30 to 45 minutes in order for there to be a benefit. And while it's true that if you can consistently practice anything, it becomes a stronger skill, and mindfulness is no exception. However, you don't have to jump in and bite off more than you can chew. As the old saying goes, how do you eat an elephant? And the answer? One bite at a time. One, when you wake up in the morning and you go to brush your teeth, or when you brush your teeth before you go to bed, or whenever you're brushing your teeth, simply pay as much attention as you possibly can to everything that's happening inside of your mouth. Pay attention to the bristles as they hit your gums. Pay attention to the bristles as it's on your tongue. Just pay attention to everything that you're doing. The sensation of the toothpaste, of the water, of the foam. Pay attention and see if you can't keep your awareness completely on the sensations happening in your mouth. Just like any other mindfulness exercise, if you notice that you're brushing your teeth and you start to think about the bills you have to pay tomorrow, bring your attention back to what you're doing. Now, not only is this good for a mindfulness practice, but it's also good for oral hygiene. Two, and I've talked about this before in two simple ways to begin a mindfulness practice, is when you're drinking a beverage. Now, a hot beverage gives you a few more things to pay attention to, but a cold beverage will do just fine. Once again, simply bring your attention to all the sensations you have when you're engaging with this drink. So if it's coffee, you can pay attention to the warmth as it goes down your throat, the taste of the bitterness or the sweetness, depending how much sugar you've put in. You could pay attention to the steam coming off of a hot cup of coffee or tea. If you're drinking a bottle of water, you could pay attention to the condensation on the outside of the bottle. You could pay attention to the ice bumping around in the glass. And of course, you can pay attention to the sensation of the water or the flavor or whatever it is you're drinking as it is on your tongue and goes down your throat. The second simple way. Three, anytime you are getting up to walk from one spot to the next, you have an opportunity to try a mindfulness activity. Simply pay attention to your foot strikes on the floor. Now, if you've got leather bottom shoes or you've got heels and you're walking on a hard surface, you can actually utilize the sound of your footsteps as you move from where you are to where you're going. Click, clack, click, clack, click, clack, paying attention. If you're on softer material or even on harder surfaces, you can simply also just pay attention to the sensation of the floor as your feet settle and press against the floor. So pay attention to the pressure on the bottoms of your feet as you walk. This can be done anytime, any place you are moving from point A to point B. You have to remember, and so perhaps in your cell phone, you set off mindful walking as an alarm, and you get up and you do your mindful walk. As you get up to move from your desk to go take a bathroom break, mindful walking. As you are on your way from your car to the place that you work or to the school building, mindful walking. As you get up in the morning out of bed to go downstairs, and you're going down the stairs, mindful walking. There are ample opportunities to put some mindfulness into your day, your basic daily routines. This is the third way. The fourth way, mindful writing, mindful typing. As you're writing, pay attention to what the sensations are of the instrument that you're using to write with. It could even be a stylus if you're using your phone. And you can also pay attention to the keys as you press them, as you're typing them. Now, this may be more difficult because you may actually be reading something as you type, but it is possible if you're responding to pay attention just for a moment to what you're actually doing, the sensations on the bottom of your fingers as you're typing. Doesn't have to be very long. It only needs to be for a moment or two. It's still making you more aware of our everyday behaviors, of our everyday actions, and adding mindfulness one small bit at a time. And then finally, mindful transportation. Now I say mindful transportation because it could be that you go to work or to the grocery store or wherever by car, by bus, by train, and for some people who are flying, by plane. So pay attention when you're moving through time and space to what's actually going on around you. How often do you get into your car or get on the bus or on the train and the world just zips by outside and you are not aware? You're in your head, you're thinking. This is a prime opportunity to pay attention to what's actually happening right here, right now in the present, to be mindful. Now, if you're driving or riding your bike or riding a skateboard or any of these things, running even, paying attention is required and will make the experience not only more safe, but it should make you a better runner, cyclist, driver all by itself. And it'll strengthen your ability to be mindful, to be present right here and right now. And while you're trying any one of these five approaches, I ask you to just also pay attention to the amount of thoughts that are coming at you, the speed, the frequency of these thoughts. Notice if there is a difference. Most people report when doing mindfulness type activities, when paying attention to the right here, right now, it dampens, it softens, and it slows the mind's thought processes. It allows us to step back. It allows us to slow things down, at least in our heads. Obviously, we're not slowing down what's going on around us, but we are slowing down how quickly our mind is working to get out in front. And if you're dealing with anxiety or you're dealing with social pressures or social phobias, this is a key element to slowing it down and being able to manage those anxiety levels. So we've got the five places. Pick just one and play with that, putting mindfulness into our simple daily routines. One small bite at a time.